So here I stand at last in front of the 55 Chevy, and this video has been a long time coming. I would say definitely the longest one that I've been saying and talking about and telling you guys about, and then something else comes up, something happens. And part of it's me, the car has actually been back and done for the past couple of months, but we've talked about it before, I'm not gonna go into it again. So this vehicle I actually bought back in February. So if you do the math, yeah, it's been a while. And got it from the guy, I actually went up, rode in the car, listened to the car, checked it all out and everything like that. And guy said, it's great shape, great condition, a little dated on the build, as you guys can probably tell from behind, but we'll talk about that in a second. But I decided I wanted it, got him to deliver it for me. He pulls it off. Remember him telling me specifically, he goes, this vehicle does not leak a drop of oil. So when I got off the vehicle, I left it in the shop overnight, came out the next morning, and he was absolutely right. It doesn't leak a drop of oil. It leaked like puddles of oil and buckets of oil, or at least small 10 cans worth of oil. So I thought, okay, take it over to the workshop, have Eddie go ahead and get the oil leak fixed. Just do a few things, a few preventive maintenance things and everything like that. So when he got over there, he said, yeah, we should probably go ahead and, like, you know, spark plug wires, belt hoses, that type of thing. And then it just kind of went downhill from there. The first thing and the most biggest thing is that we lost second and third gear. So that was a bit of a problem. And so that was a little bit of a hassle to get a new transmission, and then ended up having some issues with the brakes, a master cylinder, booster, that type of thing. Issues with windows, windows wouldn't go up. It just kind of kept on going and going and going. And because of the way this thing is built, the transmission behind it really isn't the most ideal transmission for this setup, but I'll talk about that as we go through the vehicle. Let's just take a quick walk around and I'll show you. This paint really needs to be seen in person because it's kind of a chameleon color. The flames are really, really awesome. And even though, like, the checkered flag thing down the side kind of dates it. It did have center lines on it before, which really dated it. I think the interior also kind of dates it. It's still just a really neat build, and I get a kick out of it. I actually just took it to the gas station a few minutes ago, and I had two people while I was filling up stop and compliment the car. So let's go around here and show you guys what is under the hood. That is a 468 big block. As you can see, it does have air conditioning that I need to have charged and serviced. Has fans on both sides to expel the hot air, which is kind of cool. And it's a nice sounding, nice running motor. So you got a little mirror image going on up there, which was more popular probably 20, 25 years ago when this thing was built. Now inside is kind of some tweed. You can see the flames in the door panels, both door panels. And then, I don't know if you can really see it, but the headliner is also tweed with the flames up there. Kind of cool, though. I thought this was really kind of cool, is the way that the back end was done, the three rear seats, a seat that sits up kind of higher. My son sits there when we take this car out and he loves it. But it's just all tweed. See the gauges there, full assortment of gauges, and then the shifter down there. Now, one thing you will notice as I'm going along the car, there are no door handles. Yep, no door handles at all. It's got the poppers. I'm not a big fan. I like exterior door handles. So one of the things I am going to do to this car is I'm going to put exterior door handles and all the hardware inside so I can open the vehicle from the outside. That way I can roll the windows up. It does have poppers underneath, and it's supposed to pop with a little key fob thing. And then there's some hidden handles inside, which is kind of cool. But I'm not a door popper kind of guy. So another thing that's kind of cool, this car was built, you can see that those rear fender skirts are removable, which you need to have in order to be able to get the rear tires off. Without it, you'd have to drop the rear end down, which is kind of a pain. I'll show you guys in the trunk. Nothing to get excited about. Like I said, this is an older build, so it's dated. But see the air tank, it does have air shocks up front. Manual fuel pump, fill the fuel up right there. And yeah, you can see, I mean, the carpet's kind of stained, even though I've had it all detailed. But again, the flames continue here in the trunk. When it's all said and done, I do really like this car. It's not horribly fast. It does sound good. It has exhaust bypass, so you can open up and run on open headers, which is cool. I do like that. And it's a nice cruising car. Now, I talked about the transmission. Right now, like I said, it's a 468 big block. It's a 700R transmission, and I believe it's a Ford 9-inch, and I believe it has 456 gears in it. I was able to get a lot of information off the old eBay ad, and apparently this was in a magazine years ago. I don't know how far back, but it was in a magazine, so that's kind of cool with the notoriety. But getting back to the transmission, when I went down to have Al and Nathan at Al's Transmission build a transmission for this, they were talking like, you know, 700R is not the best for a big block, big tubbed, big rear tires, that type of thing. If you're going to drive it hard, you're going to drive it aggressive. Transmission's probably not going to last. So they ended up taking it on anyway. Nathan ended up building it with a manual valve body, all really good internals. I spent a good little chunk of change on this transmission. And, you know, he still does not recommend hard launches, burnouts, that type of thing, which is okay. That's not me. That's not what I do. I'm okay with that. You know, I just like to run it out through a couple of gears and then step out of it, and I'm good. So the transmission shifts great. It seems great. I like the manual valve body. I actually prefer that in a vehicle like this. So that actually worked out really well. This vehicle does have tilt telescopic. It's got power windows, and it does, like I said, have AC. I'm going to take it down tomorrow. That's the reason I'm doing the video today, because I know it might be gone for a little bit. I do want to have Jesse take a look at the air conditioning and service that. Also, the brakes. It's got good brakes, but I don't have a lot of brake pedal. I mean, I'm almost on the floor when I come to a full and complete stop, and that just makes me nervous. I just feel like there's something there that we're missing. Something's not going on. So I'm going to have Jesse check that out, maybe give it an alignment. And then, as I said, I do want to put the exterior door handles on, so I want to get all the hardware and everything like that for that part of it. And the last thing I think I would probably do on this car, and I think I may do it, I'm going to see how much it would cost, is to gut the interior and go through and do with like a leather looking material, something a little bit more modern, something that looks a little bit more up to date, that type of thing. So we're talking headliner, carpet, everything into the trunk. So if it's not horrible, I think I will do that. The reason I've kind of procrastinated on this is because I'm really not sure how long I'm going to keep the car. I mean, I like the car. I do dig the car, but then there's a part of me that says, I don't know if I'm going to take it to Tennessee with me. So is it worth putting the money into it? But, you know, I do see it being here for a few years. I like my Tri-5s, and this is, I mean, I liked my 56. It was a really cool car. This is just a different animal altogether, and it's got the look, it's got the sound, it's a good cruiser. So I do think I'm going to do that, assuming it's not like a huge amount of money to do the interior. If it is, then I'm going to leave it alone. So, yeah, I think that's really everything I can tell you about the car itself. Let's fire it up and take it around the block, see how it runs. I just put fuel in it, which is good. This thing really does like fuel a lot. But all the gauges run good. It's charging good. Water temperature's good. Running right around 30, 35 pounds of oil pressure just idling right now, so that's good. Everything seems good. Take it down this way. Like I said, it is a manual valve body, so I gotta shift manually, which I like. I really do. Noticing at low RPMs when I shift, it has just a little drop off right there. That's when it's not under much of a load. When you put it under a load, it seems to pick up pretty good and there's no hesitation. So this would probably be a really good candidate to maybe step into fuel injection instead of the carburetor. We'll see if I decide to keep it. I'm not really sure. I've always wanted to, you know, go with like a Holley Sniper or something like this. And I mean, this motor, when I was reading the eBay ad, it said it was like right around 500 horse or something like that. I don't think it's that. Maybe 400, maybe 450 at the crank. But it's just, it's got a really, really nice sound to it. And it's actually with the, even though it's got 456s with that 700R, it cruises really nicely. Now I do have the windows down. It's not horribly warm today, but so you might get a little bit of wind noise. I do apologize. Just gotten used to keeping the windows down with the poppers and everything like that, but I'll step into it a little bit. One thing I've noticed with all the Pro Street cars that I've had, they all feel a little wallowy, that's a word. Like it just kind of wallows a little bit to me. And I don't know if that's a normal thing. I assume it is because, you know, I've had, what, 4 or 5 Pro Street cars and they've all been kind of the same way. And this one's definitely no exception. Pretty good little cam. I do really like that sound. The way the pedals are set up, it's like the only vehicle I 2-foot drive. I feel more comfortable doing that, especially with the limited brake pedal. Let's see if I can step into it just a little bit here. Up, it jumps pretty good. It chirped a little second there. So, and these are big tires. These are huge tires. I think these tires are probably as big, if not bigger, than the ones that were on my Pro Street Chevelle. And I mean, that thing was pushing 1,000 horsepower to the ground. This is not pushing anywhere near that. So, but I also have to keep in mind too that this vehicle is turning a very big tire and it's not the lightest vehicle in the world out there. So, but. Giving her the beans. So, yeah, let's get back to the shop. I'll wrap everything up. So, that's not the most I've driven this vehicle, but, you know, collectively, I'll bet I haven't probably put more than 25, maybe 30 miles total. And, I mean, I drove when I first got, took around the block a couple of times. That was fun. Then it went down. Then I drove it kind of in a between stage. I drove it after, like, Nathan got the transmission together. And then drove it home from the workshop. And then my wife and I and my son took it to a Cars and Coffee maybe a month ago, a month and a half ago, something like that. And so it was fun. I mean, it was fun. It's got some snap. Like I said, it's not crazy fast or anything like that. But that's okay. It's really got a nice sound to it. And I didn't even open up the headers. I mean, that's with closed exhaust right there. So open up the headers, it does sound even meaner and it's much more aggressive and attacks the senses a lot more. So, you know, kind of leads me to want to keep it and want to do all this stuff and figure out a way to get it back to Tennessee. But of course, Tennessee's still 2.5-3 years away. So things could change. You never know. But I'm glad I put the time into it. I'm glad I'm getting it up and together. So even if I do end up selling it at some point, I'm gonna know that this is a squared away car, it's in good shape, it's gonna be in good shape for someone in the future. And if I keep it, I'm just gonna enjoy it. So let me know what you guys think. I know this video's been a long time coming, I've been talking about it and saying, okay, it's coming, and then something else would happen or whatever, I just get lazy, which more than likely that's my excuse over the past couple months, but we won't talk about that. So let me know what you think about it. Let me know, should I keep it? Should I take it to Tennessee? Should it be a keeper for a long period of time? Or do you think it should go someplace else and maybe replace it down the road with something different? I will give you guys a quick update. The 40, I did get everything taken care of, insurance and I are square. So thank you, Haggerty Insurance, I do appreciate it. Now I'm gonna sell the truck. I'm actually, probably it'll be up for sale or hopefully sold by the time this video hits, but I am gonna go ahead and let it go. I don't have a desire really to get in it and do anything with it. Give it to somebody who's got a passion for it. And I do, I wanna get down another vehicle anyway. So the money's more important to me at this point in time than really having another vehicle. Although you guys know me, I'm always open to trade. So if a good trade comes along, I'll do that. But someone's gonna have to put a front clip on it to get it drivable. It runs, it's good as far as mechanical, just that front suspension is gonna need some help. And I think that was probably the problem that caused the accident in the first place. But it's clean title, all's good there, nothing happened there. So anyway, long story short, it's gonna be sold to somebody. So as always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. P.O. Box, Instagram, description below. Guys, God bless, take care, have an absolutely amazing day.